नमस्कार, दिस इज डॉक्टर रेवती कामत फ्रॉम पुणे. इन आर सीरीज म्यूजिक एंड चाइल्डहुड, टुडे वी आर वेरी हैप्पी टू हैव विद अस श्रीमती अपर्णा केळकर. अपर्णा केळकर इज अ नोटेड क्लासिकल वोकलिस्ट एंड शी विल बी स्पीकिंग टू अस टुडे अबाउट हर जर्नी इन म्यूजिक एंड हर इंटरेक्शन म्यूजिकली विद हर चिल्ड्रन.
हेलो एवरीवन. हाय रेवती, इट इज़ माई एब्सोल्यूट डिलाइट टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस सीरीज. थैंक यू फॉर इन्वाइटिंग मी हियर. माई बेस्ट विशेस टू अविरतनाथ.
सो हियर्स द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू अपर्णा. स्वानंदी एंड कौशिक हैव गॉट देयर म्यूजिक फ्रॉम यू. सो इन सच अ केस, वॉज टीचिंग देम अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर लाइकिंग और डिड यू टीच देम बिकॉज यू थॉट इट वॉज कंपल्सरी?
Basically, every child comes with his own interests and likings. I think three points are super important to learn any art form: passion, training, and consistency. As you know, I am a singer and my husband Makran is also a very good music listener. But we never forced our children to learn music or to pursue music. They were always with me when I was doing riyaz, when I was in my practice sessions for my programs, in my learning process, in my teaching process. And they both have attended many music workshops and enjoyed many concerts with me. So they grew up in a naturally nurtured environment. I think knowingly, unknowingly, many things affected their senses in good terms. And about career, in my opinion, more options should be open. Swanandi Kaushik may do their career in music or may not. I think it is only their choice.
So when did you start their formal training and how did you go about it?
As I said, they both are born and brought up in musical atmosphere. We both noticed their talent. I think when Swanandi was in first or second standard, she started attending children's batch in my class. And she was always around me. She could reproduce the bandishes effortlessly. And about Kaushik, somehow we realize that he is a rhythmic child. So we gifted him a small tabla pair on his first birthday. Swanandi and Kaushik both got exposure in small programs and even in music competitions. It built their confidence. Both of them have completed 5 exams of Akhil Bharatiya Gandharva Mahavidyalaya up to Madhyama. As they are creative and of course techno savvy, they are doing background score for a short film recently. And we always appreciate their creativity and encourage them to explore musically.
So how did you manage your own learning from Pandit C.R. Vyas, who was in Mumbai, and your riyaz, and how did you balance it with teaching music and balancing the academics of your children?
Riyaz plays an essential role in every artist's life. I think it is much more than practicing for few hours daily. Learning, listening, teaching, watching, reading, everything develops your understanding. And music should flow in your mind and thoughts. I have been fortunate to have gurus who are so kind and who could understand me, and that's why I never had a problem in bringing my child for learning sessions also. I had equal support from my family, from my close friends, and so learning, teaching and performances, it became easier for me. As I said, children were always with me. They were cooperative and sincere about their studies. So I never had to look much into it. Their school activities were very innovative and unique. So school also played an important role to versatile them.
Children are often known to be moody. So did you teach according to their mood, or you insisted that this was a discipline and it has to be followed?
I'm not at all a strict mother. I trust my children. Sometimes they avoid Riyaz or their class, but I think these are phases. I have seen that their passion brings them back to music.
So today we are very happy to have Swanandi with us also today. I have seen Swanandi since she was a baby, and so I have seen her musical growth also. And it is really a pleasure to have you, Swanandi, today with us. I would like to ask you one question. You are a dentist by profession. So how did you keep music all through your such a hectic professional career? How did you manage to do your studies and yet be very active in music? Because you have been a good composer, you are a good singer. And are there any plans for you to get into music later on?
Even if I chose dentistry as my career, music has always played a vital role in my life. And my mom, being a classical vocalist, she actually never pressurized me to follow one kind of music, and she was always extremely open-minded about it, which was very supportive, I would say. My composing started when I was in school. So my school teacher actually once asked me to compose one poem for her, and that was very interesting for me, and that's how it all started. And obviously my parents were very happy about it, I would say, and helped me. I was very lucky because my childhood was enriched by a lot of experiences, which include obviously being with Vyasabha. While he was training my mother, I used to sit there. He literally treated me like his own granddaughter, and it was a great feeling. I would like to add one more point here. Even during my board exams or my final year exams, music was always a very important part of my life, because music actually relieves all my stresses, and music actually makes me feel very safe. So I don't have any specific future plans, I would say, but I know for sure that music is always going to be a important part of my life. The most important thing is whatever I have achieved in, like, musically has been extremely easy and pleasing because of my first guru, my Aayi, and the environment they have created in the house. I think it's very important.
A very warm welcome to Kaushik also. And Kaushik has been a really interested student of tabla and all the percussion instruments that he can lay his hands on. So Kaushik, I would like to ask you, what inspired you to take to tabla, or how did you get interested into this side of music, the instrumental part of music?
I was passionate about rhythm since my childhood, and I used to attend so many concerts with my parents, and I saw Bharat Kaka from very close and I was fascinated by him. I literally used to copy his moves when I was a kid. I officially started learning tabla from Sagar Samant and Pandit Suresh Samant when I was nearly 6 to 7 years old, and currently I am learning from Nikhil Phatak Dada. And I've had phases where I used to like various instruments like sarangi or side rhythms. I even used to accompany her on side rhythms when I was a kid. So I and Baba both have encouraged me during all of that. I used to visit many recording studios with Ai during her recordings, and I was really obsessed by that process. In addition to that, because of Pradeep Mali Kaka and Chandrapai Kaka, my interest in sound was enhanced. I literally used to sit next to them with their headphones on in many concerts. In 8th standard, as my school summer activity, I went to Dawn Studios to observe and learn some things for nearly 2 months, and it was a great experience.
Aparna, what do you think constitutes sanskars in music?
For every artist, art is a medium of expression, and riyaz is a multi-layered concept, and it is a lifetime process, or you can say commitment. Sur, taal, lay, all these things are included in basic riyaz. Ragas and composition study is required, obviously. Improving stamina and techniques is also important. I believe that all art forms are interconnected. We must try to develop our aesthetic sense and try to learn the basics of other arts. If we try to connect all the learnings, it gives us an holistic approach towards any art form. And for me, riyaz is not only a singing, but an internal journey.
So you have learned in an institutionalized form of learning from a private class and in the Guru Shishya Parampara. So what do you think that you have benefited from all these styles of training?
Basically, I do not have any musical family background. When I was 9-10 years old, around 9-10 years old, my school teacher told my parents that I should learn music as I have a good sense of music and maybe a good voice. आणि माझ्या आईबाबांनी अक्षरशः त्या दिवशी मला क्लासमध्ये घातलं हे त्यांचं खूप मोठं श्रेय आहे. अँड ऑन दॅट सेम डे माय पेरेंट्स टूक मी टू विष्णू दिगंबर संगीत विद्यालय. And my journey in classical music began from a group in a music class. We used to sing many taranas, sargams, bandishes there. And singing together was fun. Along with my BA, I started learning from Srimati Purnimatai Talwalkar, who was a disciple of Pandit C.R. Vyas. After few years, Purnimatai requested Vyasbua to teach me, and he accepted me as his disciple. It was a great honor for me, and those one-to-one sessions gave me insights about music. After Guruji's demise, I went to Dr. Arvind Thatte, a well-known musician, for my further training. Along with my senior Guru Bandhu, Shri Ram Shintre Kaka. I am so fortunate that I could learn from such distinguished gurus.
So you've taught at the college level also, and you've taught and you're still teaching children in your classes also. So is there any sort of difference that you find that training to college students and the students at your place need to be given different type of training?
I have grown through music class to Guru Shishya Taleem. I think in common group, children can learn from each other also. Fireball training regarding the music exams is very important because you have to complete given syllabus of both practical and theory in the given time. Also, understanding the notation is of utmost importance according to me. But to be a performer, you have to sit in front of a guru and take taleem. Learning, observing, and interacting with the guru helps us to widen our vision of music. So in music, there is no other option to Guru Shishya Parampara. Guru and parents are equally responsible for a child's development. During stressful schedules, like in board exams, music can help you to relax. I always try to bring the best out of my students. I'm committed to them. And some of my students are very serious about music. I'm trying to train them all round, and it is my pleasure.
So coming to the last part of our conversation, Aparna, I would like to know if you would like to share some experiences or some thoughts with us for our audience today so that they will be benefited.
We are very happy that Swanandi and Kaushik are so open to appreciate all type of good music. We practice, we share, and we enjoy music thoroughly. So it is my advice that let your child explore what he likes. Be open about his choices. Don't force him. Do listen to him. Just be there for him and encourage him. And introduce him to new art forms. A friendship with any art will grow and enrich his life. And Revati, thank you again for inviting me here. Thank you.
Well, coming to the end of our conversation today, I wouldn't thank all three of you because you're a part of my family. So, but I must mention that I have been indeed very happy to have all of you on this platform today. And from Avirat Nath family, we wish you all the best for all your future endeavors. Thank you so much.
माझे आई वडील, माझे सगळे गुरु आणि संगीतात सहकार्य करणारे माझे व्यासंगी मित्रमैत्रिणी आणि इतरही माझे प्रोत्साहन देणारे मित्रमैत्रिणी आणि ऑफकोर्स माझी फॅमिली, माझी मुलं यांच्यामुळे माझा सांगीतिक प्रवास आणि आयुष्य सुंदर चालू आहे. विल एंड अप दिस सेशन विथ स्वानंदीज कंपोजिशन, विच इज माय फेवरेट कंपोजिशन.
बोलताना पाहिले मी वृक्षास डोलताना, वृक्षास डोलताना, हलकेच पाहिले